going? Hope you guys are doing fine. Please do not mind my voice. I've been having this nasty cough for some time now, which will go away. Yes, it will go away. So I bring you guys good news. I bring you guys not so good news. I bring you guys gist. Yes, so gist. That is why I am here, and I'm sure that is why you clicked on this video. Okay, let's go straight to the point. So at the Pepsi party, I'm still talking Big Brother, yeah? So at the Pepsi party where Jackie was handed over her 1.5 million naira and her trip to Dubai, yeah, she won that in the house. We noticed some kind of things. Yes, I noticed some kind of things with Kafi and Gedoni. Now, earlier, I don't know if I reported it on my channel, but both of them unfollowed each other on Instagram. Yes, both of them unfollowed each other because Gedoni was seen doing rough play with his ex-girlfriend, who did not waste any time to post it on social media so we all can see. And I guess that kind of made Kafi to be like, okay, I think I need to take a break from this guy. But we now saw the picture after the party the next day. Ha! Kafi posted her own. Now said, hashtag black, hashtag his color. I was like, okay, who is he? Only for me to go to get on his page. And I saw hashtag yellow, hashtag her color. I'm like, ho, 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 ho. And the both pictures were taken by Nelson. I'm like, okay. Are these people doing something on the low? On the low? Maybe they are doing something on the low they don't want us to know. But no, 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 no. We, the APROCO Association of Nigeria, we are going to find out. You're not going to hide your relationship from social media. I'm sorry. You're not going to hide it from us. Because when you were busy doing the lovey-lovey, when the relationship started, we were there. So you have to show us how the relationship has been going and going. Because we invested our time, our energy, and our... what else did we invest? Our subscription on the relationship. So we are part of the relationship. So Kafi and Gedoni cannot do a play a fast one on us and think you can take us away from the relationship. It is not your relationship. It is our relationship. Okay, talking about relationships, let's talk about Esther and Fraud. Now, you know how Fraud was all out for Esther in the house. My guy don't change you. Like, he came out of the house and during one of the interviews some days ago, this guy said there was nothing between him and Esther. I'm like, hey, uncle. He even denied the fact where he said that he has not washed Esther's undies before. That's Esther's pants, her pants. He had not washed it before. I'm like, hey, Oga Fraud, you are a fraud. You are a really, really, really big fraud. Like, how? How could you say that? How could you say that? Because we saw you. In fact, you guys remember that time both of them were lying down and Fred was like, I've watched everything, meaning the toll. Like, okay, if you have watched everything, that means you watched everything now. Abi? Well, Fred said he and Esther are just friends. There's nothing there. Esther was not having it. Esther just went straight on, unfollow button. She pressed the unfollow button. Now, Fred also unfollow her. And at some point, both of them started unfollowing each other. Yeah. And Esther, you know, she got an endorsement from PayPal and she's living the baby girl life. Yes, she's living the baby girl life. And Fraud came out. A lot of people were bashing him. You know, Fraud came out to say, oh, it's not like that, that he has to concentrate. In fact, I didn't even understand anything he was saying. Basically, what I understand is there's nothing between us. No matter the English in use, big English, small English, everything mean, there's nothing between us. So I think that is how the whole ship has scattered. Now, a lot of people are saying that maybe there is a ship with Fraud and our auntie Juliet Ibrahim. That is what some people are saying, though. Me, I am not sure. Because the fact that they got all cozy during one of the parties does not mean that there's something now, Abi. The fact that you are, because you can be in a party and you are holding somebody doesn't mean you have anything for the person. But let us see, because my APROCOMETER is watching. Whatever happens, I'll bring to you guys. Now, moving on. You also know about Esther. You know how Jaruma said that Esther and Nina are going to be meeting with her in Dubai to spike Tacha because of her fallout with Tacha. Yeah? Now, I woke up, was it 2 days ago? And I saw that Jaruma has deleted all those posts about Esther. I'm like, hey, what is going on? only for me to realize that she has actually unfollowed Esther. I was happy. I opened and a lot of people were happy. They were even saying, ah, the queen of space and queen of special facial expressions, which is Esther, that they were even congratulating her, because a lot of people didn't want Esther to be in the same position that Tasha was, you know. Yeah, they didn't want that. So I was happy with her. So what do you guys think? Do you guys think that Jaruma was trying to use Esther as a pawn in her game? Anyways, talking about Jaruma. So it was a billionaires connection meeting in Dubai, yo. Yes, so because Jaruma, Tony Lawani, and Regina, they were seen with their not with Tony Lawani. I didn't see any plus one for Tony Lawani, but I saw Regina's husband, Mr. Ned Wonko, and Jaruma's mute husband. Yeah, I said mute because I've never seen him talk. Anyways, but all of them were lounging, living the billionaires life. Yeah, the billionaires life in tennis. Italy's voice, yes. Billionaire's life in Dubai. Somebody should come and take me to Dubai, you. I am due for going to Dubai. Anyways, moving on. Now let's talk about Tasha. Yes, Tasha. Everywhere, Tasha. So you all know that there's been a media round for all the housemates, the five finalists, and it's all about 90% of it has always been about Tasha, yeah. So the one that really made Tasha to come out to like tweet something was the one where Shay's girlfriend actually came out to say I trust my man. After all, Tasha is not her type. His type. Hey, even though she even tried to redeem herself by saying, I didn't mean it that well. I didn't mean it. Nigerians were not having it. The Titans were not having it. We're like, hey, should we remind this girl what happened on so day? Should we remind her this? Ah, Auntie Opakwe, you should even be grateful that Tasha didn't have your August time. You should even be grateful that Tasha was in a relationship with her boyfriend Ladi, her twin Ladi. That if not, Shayida was carrying Tasha's matter on his head, that the only time he remembered to bring out your picture was when he and Tasha were not in good terms. I'm like, hey, Nigerian, so now get chill. If you see the way they were roasting the girl alive, I went to her page, I went to see you, only for me to see the girl don't put that page is on private. I'm like, okay, if it's me too, I'll put my page on private too. Even self, people started comparing her and Tasha. Do you know what even made? In fact, Shayna posted that picture where they were kissing. And where they were not kissing, she was wearing one blue jacket. And she was wearing that dress that Tasha had. Tasha had that particular dress. Yeah, so remember the day that, I'm trying to remember the day she wore it. Okay, yeah. Remember the day she came out from the secret room where they welcomed that dress, yes, I don't forget that dress. She wore that kind of dress and she wore that Tasha's Cleopatra kind of week. Yes, I call it Cleopatra week. And a lot of people were now comparing. I'm like, hey, Nigerians, Africans, una, well done. No, anyway, so moving on, let's talk about Tasha now. So I woke up this morning and I checked my phone and I saw Dotun. If you don't know Dotun, he is an OAP on L Personality, working for he works at Cool FM, one of the biggest radio stations in Nigeria, and he posted that he is going to be interviewing Simply Tasha, that is Tasha's name on Instagram, Tasha, on Wednesday, this week's Wednesday, by 12 p.m. on the Midday Oasis show. Everywhere went agog. A lot of people were happy. I was happy because it's time to hear her own side of the story. I've been hearing from every other person. I've been hearing from other housemates. I've been saying what I'm saying based on what I saw. It's time to hear from the host's mouth, or what you guys think. So I was very excited, only for me to check my phone and Dotun was now saying that he was receiving death threats, that he's about to cancel it, that unless Tasha and her team release a press release, yeah, that the interview might not hold, that actually he did not ask for this, that her management begged him. I'm like, no. At that point, okay, you got to match break. You got to match break, because I feel if you are being professional, I don't know about being a professional, what's in the column, journalist, that is if it is what it is, but you don't go around telling people that somebody begged you to interview somebody. Like, that's just my own. But for those that are selling death threats, now show, Now the show has ended. Now a lot of people are saying that it's Thatcher's fans, that they did it because that you all know Dotun. If you don't know Dotun, at least you know Tunde Ednod. Tunde Ednod and Dotun, like Dotun was like Tunde Ednod's sidekick when it comes to trolling Thatcher. Like, he did it. He openly trolled the girl. Now he's coming out to tell people that it's a game, that he doesn't, he's about to back down from the interview because of the trolling and the death threat. I'm like, Oga, now you just realize it's a game, right? You really understand now that it's a game, right? When you, like, don't troll people. That's the bottom line. Don't troll people. I'm not on anybody's side, but the thing is, don't troll people. You know, a lot of people are like, oh, so you trolled her, you did not understand it's a game, now she's out, and people are giving you a dose of your own medicine and you are not liking it. My point in all this, whether Dotun gets a death threat or not, I feel the moment he gets a death threat, it's way too far. I can understand his concerns. It's way too far. So whoever is doing this, be it a titan or a non-titan, I think you guys should chill. Thatcher is trying to rebrand herself. She's trying to get a new lease life. Yeah, so because she has every potential to be great. Yes, I said it. She has every potential to be great. So it didn't even take like 2 minutes after he said that. Tbilisi, yes, Tbilisi is actually Thatcher's new manager. If you don't know Tbilisi, he's actually the ex-husband and the father of Tiwa Savage's son and also her ex-husband. He's one of the people that managed Tiwa Savage before he went through a very dark patch, a rough patch in life, where he had issues with drugs, he had issues, he almost committed suicide at some point, but thanks to people like Banky W that helped him get him out of it. Now he even when Thatcher was disqualified, he said that he's gonna make sure she becomes the King Kardashian of Africa. Yes, and he's keeping to his word. He's signed her onto his team, or welcomed her to his team and all that. So he came out and released a press statement. In the press statement he did on social media, he apologized to Dotun and also asked all the Thatchers to please calm down, that they are trying to sell Thatcher to the world so that she can achieve her full potentials and all that. So yeah, that's a good one. That's a good one. I appreciate that. Let's see. I'm so looking forward to her media tour. Like, I'm so looking forward to Thatcher talking, because it's high time we hear from her. What you think? So that we can have food to eat, bloggers like us. Anyways, there also seems to be some kind of issues in the camp of Mercy, because you know MC Galazi has been handling her Instagram page or her social media handles, but both of them unfollowed each other. Apparently this happened because Mercy refused for MC Galazi to continue managing her, that she got a new management, and she even posted on her Insta story about her new management and her number, her new management number for any business and all that, and MC Galazi was not having it, so he unfollowed her. Well, that brings me to what I want to say. Yeah, the fact that you are voting for someone, the fact that you love someone, the fact that you decide to reach out to help someone to win something, doesn't mean, let's get this entitlement mentality, because she actually appreciated him. You know, she actually went out of her way to appreciate him. I think that should be enough. Or I don't know, because life does not begin and end on social media. So maybe there are some things that went, you know, behind the scenes that we are not yet open with or conversant with. And before I forget, happy birthday to the Warri guy himself, Omoshola. Yes, today was his, did I say was? Oh my goodness. Today is his birthday. A lot of fellow housemates celebrated him yesterday, thinking yesterday was his birthday, but I know that it's actually today. So I am saying a happy birthday to Omoshola. Today is his birthday. What's that thing he usually say? Oh, blah, blah. blah blah, whatever that means, I don't even know. Yesterday at Quilox, they celebrated him. His fellow housemates or ex-housemate rather came and they all celebrated him. Diane was looking somehow, but it's all good. They all celebrated him, and yeah, finally Mike met MC Oluomo. He report all of them. It was so hilarious. Mike and his wife Perry, they went on to visit MC Oluomo. If you see the way MC Oluomo was just grinning from ear to ear, it's been a fun week. It's been a fun week for the ex-housemates. They are cruising, cashing out, you know, money everywhere. Wallahi, I should go for next year. Who knows? They might raise the money to 100 million naira. Hey, imagine your girl, Ezinne Williams, getting the money. And then you'll be like, hey, I know her. That should be beautiful. You know, because I need all this money in my life. I need all this money. Every day I'm seeing this one team, this one got 1 million, this one got 1 million. If you calculate the money of these guys are getting, leave adultment aside though. Like, they are cashing out big time. See, if you are in support of us going for Big Brother next year, say aye. Even if you don't say it and I'm seeing it, just write it down in the comment section. Guys, tell me what you think about this whole Tacha, how the interview is going to go, about Gedoni and Kafi, about Mercy and MC Galazi. What you guys think about this? I'm Fraud and Esther. Let me know what you guys think down in the comment section. Thank you guys for being part of my channel. Thank you guys for loving me. Thank you for being with me, for starting this journey with me. Like play. We are here. Thank you so much. I appreciate all of you. All the criticisms I get, all the love I get, all the encouragement, the mails. Thank you so very much. I love you guys. So if you're new to the channel, kindly click on the subscription button to subscribe. If you've already subscribed but you've not already pressed that notification bell, please do. You know what it does? It lets you know whenever I post any new video.